Thank you all so much for being here tonight, culminating spring concert. These students have worked so hard all year, so I hope you will sit back and just enjoy a ton of music these students have prepared for you tonight. The next group to perform will be our string ensemble, Brahms Hungarian Dance No. 1. The next two pieces will be performed by our vocal ensemble. The first one, Lebenslust by Franz Schubert, will be sung entirely in German, and it's a German madrigal that's translated basically about the joy of living, the joy of living. Immediately following that, we're going to go to the opposite end of life. Remember not, Lord, our offenses is a song that is usually sung at funerals, Henry Purcell. And it is asking forgiveness from the Lord. Two beautiful contrasting styles of music, both opposite ends of the spectrum of life. Really kind of cool to put these two pieces together. Makes you think. Lebenslust, Franz Schubert, followed by Henry Purcell.
Sailing in, Lucy, sailing.
This next piece, Andantino from Tchaikovsky Symphony No. 4, will feature the opening solo by our concertmaster Matthew Garcia. This is Tchaikovsky's Andantino. Thank you. This next piece will be performed by our wind ensemble. This is Gustav Holst's second suite in F. We've been playing all four movements all year long for all of our different performances and festivals. The first one is titled March, second one, Song Without Words. We'll be performing movement 3 and 4 tonight. Movement 3, entitled Blacksmith, you'll hear the banging of metal on metal that is supposed to be the blacksmith. It's very loud, played by Tadeo Acosta Rubio. You can't miss it. And then Song of Dargazon. Dargazon is an Anglo-Saxon word that actually means dwarf. And you can see if you can depict any images when you hear the fourth movement. So this is the third and fourth movement of Gustav Holst's second suite in F. Yeah, that's a tough piece of music. They've done an amazing, amazing job on that piece this year. And it's even longer. It's twice as long with all the movements. The next piece, The Road Home, is a beautiful, beautiful piece, the words especially. So listen carefully to the words. It's about leaving home and always knowing that you can come back home. And it's a really beautiful piece that we usually sing at graduation. We won't be singing it at graduation this year. The students love it, so they prepared it in about a week. Maybe just a touch longer than a week. So it's very impressive. And I would like to dedicate this song to all of our seniors. So the next piece of music is a very special piece because in all the years I've been teaching, we've never taken a student conductor to festival before. And this year we tried it for the first time with strings. And what that means is not only does the student conduct the song, but they also rehearse the song. The director is not allowed to rehearse the song, which means that the person that conducts it has to hear all the nuances, make phrasing, find the wrong notes and the wrong rhythms and fix it. And this is a beautiful piece of music, Evening Song by Haydn. And our friend John Howard will be conducting, who receives superior at both district and state level as a student conductor. John Howard.
Thank you. Thank you. I'd like to dedicate this piece to a very special person in my life.
someone who inspires me every single day and who I'll miss dearly next year, my mom.
Not too bad for a little conductor there, right? He might be onto something. This next piece it will also be performed by the strings, and I'm not gonna remember what these mean, but I'm gonna tell you here. These are Romanian folk dances, and I'm not about to pronounce the titles. So I'm gonna tell you what each one means, and you can imagine the Romanian folk songs and dances that these are supposed to emulate as a string ensemble. The first one is Dance with Sticks. The second one is Horn Dance, where there's no horns. And then the next one is a Romanian polka, and that one goes right into a fast dance. There will be brief pauses between 1 and 2 and 2 and 3, but movements 3 and 4 segue right into one another. This is a really fun piece by Béla Bartók, Romanian folk dances. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. All right, moving back to our wind ensemble, this next piece, Longford Legend, is composed by Robert Sheldon. It seems that recently we do a piece by Robert Sheldon every year. Number one, he's an amazing composer. And number two, he visits us every February to come work with our students. And there is no experience like having the composer of a piece of music come in and tell them exactly what he intended. This is a three-movement work based on three different Irish poems. And he explained each poem to the students, and it transformed the way that they played this piece. I'm not going to get into them now. They're very long. But it's really, really awesome. They enjoy playing it. This is Longford Legend by Robert Sheldon. Thank you.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Oh, there must be a God somewhere.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Oh, there must be a God somewhere.
And when I'm feeling lonely,
I hear music in the air.
And when I'm feeling lonely,
I hear music in the air.
And when I'm feeling lonely,
I hear music in the air.
Oh, there must be a God somewhere.
Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Over my head, I hear music in the air. Oh, there must be a God somewhere.
When the world is silent,
I hear music in the air.
Oh, when the world is silent,
I hear music in the air.
Oh, when the world is silent,
I hear music in the air.
Oh, oh, there must be a God somewhere.
Sebastian Fernandez.
Okay, the following piece of the first half, prior to ceremony, will be strings and band combined. It's a really fun piece. It's a medley of the music from the movie. So I hope you enjoy. After this song, there will be a 15 to 20 minute intermission so that we can change the stage for jazz band. And believe me, you're not going to want to miss jazz band. And thank you to Ariel Acosta Rubio for hosting with Churomania outside. So thank you for that. And also Lina Trujillo and all the parents that put together all of this amazing stuff. Thank you so much, Carlene Pernancy. Thank you so much for all of that hard work. I will have more thank yous at the end of the jazz band set, so we're going to get right to this one, Pirates of the Caribbean.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Strings, band, chorus. Thank you. Thank you so much. I hope you worked up an appetite. Go outside, enjoy some churros and some water, I think is what we have. And come back in about 15 to 20 minutes. You're not going to want to miss the jazz band, guys. Thank you. Jeremiah, we've got Melanie Michaels, we've got Chris Ricardo, we've got Jason Filer on the quintet. You're going to hear from Brandon Suarez on an alto sax solo and then Chris Ricardo on a trumpet solo. This is Whisper Not.
Thank you.
Yeah, Brandon Suarez on alto sax and Chris Ricardo on muted trumpet. Awesome. All right, we're going to feature Chris on the flugelhorn on a Sammy Nestico arrangement of I Remember Clifford.
Thank you. Chris.
All right. So for the next chart, I've got you under my skin. We are going to welcome to the stage Blanca Garcia, who will be our vocalist. Can she please come on up to the stage? Blanca Garcia. All right, for this next chart, Cherokee, we are going to allow our jazz combo to entertain you. This group has performed all over the place this year. It's the most performing group I think we have. Yeah, they've been playing everywhere, gigs, paid gigs. They're really, really phenomenal. So they're going to be featured tonight in Cherokee. They received Superior with distinction. They played some charts from memory.
They've just done a phenomenal job this year. So if I could have the jazz combo come forward, let's make Cherokee happen.
Yeah. Check, 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 check. Chris Ricardo, Brandon Suarez, Kyle Bramson, Jake Fine, John Howard, Tadeo Costa Rubio, the Jazz Combo. Now we are going to bring up the lovely Alex Ortiz singing You Are the Sunshine of My Life.
That's why I'll always be here. here.
Alex Ortiz. Nice job, Alex. Kyle Bramson on the tenor solo. All right, so we're going to let these guys rest their chops just for a quick second here. I got some thank yous I want to share, and then some prep music music awards, their annual music awards. So let me see how I can do this here. Samantha Taylor Tamayo, where is you? There she is. Give her a big round of applause. These are for you, darling. Thank you for I bribed her with flowers so she can help me do the rest of this here. Okay, so there are a few people that I'd like to thank. A couple of parents that have really been helpful this year. If we could, we'll bring these over. And then we'll start with the flowers, actually. Let's start with the ones in the wood boxes there. Okay, so we have two parents that are really, truly helpful, and we'd like them to come up to the stage and be recognized. Carlene Punancy and Lena Trujillo, if you could come up to the stage, please. There she is. These ladies have been amazing. They've spearheaded all of the amazing things. They hooked up these amazing balloons for us, the intermission outside, anything that we need. These two lovely ladies have been there for us. Please give them a huge round of applause. We've got three more people over there with that I'd like to recognize, and they're actually students. And these three ladies have done just an amazing job as the executive officers of our music club this year. We've performed at the Camillus House, we've performed at the Lotus House, we've performed at the American Legion, and this is all because of these three ladies who have really taken charge. So if we could have Brigitte Isom, if we could have Kellyanne Cosentino, and Julia Izquierdo, come up to the stage, please. Come on out, girls. Thank you, ladies. That is not an easy job to get all of that stuff organized. Some other people I'd like to thank, administration, faculty, staff, thank you so much for being here and supporting all this hard work that these musicians have put on. Ariel Acosta Rubio, did you guys enjoy Chirtlemania outside? Where is he? Where is he? There he is. There he is, right there. That guy, right there. Muchas gracias, senor. My wife, Melissa, Mrs. C, for chaperoning, attire fittings, concert productions, concert programs. Just stand and wave. Where are you? There she is right there. Thank you. Megan Aspiazzo and her crew for doing all the posters, the banners, the tickets, the postcards, and actually the printing of the programs. I'm not sure if you're here, but thank you to Communications and Megan Aspiazzo. And then a huge crowd here. If you are a private lesson teacher, please stand up and be recognized. Private lesson teachers, stand up and be recognized. Stand up, stand up. Tony, you're a stand up. Thank you so much for all you do. This can't happen without you. Thank you so much. The entire University of Miami staff, when we got here at 4 o'clock, I had about 20 students signed up to set up the stage. When we all walked in, all 20 of us saw the stage already set up. and they're doing our recording, our amplification. Please thank the University of Miami staff. Thank you. Thank you. Mr. Mike Silver, who is streaming. Where's Mike? Where's Mr. Silver? He's streaming this concert live. Thank you, Mike. The maintenance department, and especially Larry Barley, for driving our truck with all of our instruments from the prep to here. It's not a short haul to get all these trucks here. So maintenance department, thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. And then the last one, if you are a Gulliver Prep music alum, please stand up. Gulliver Prep music alum, stand up, stand up, stand up. Yeah. Without you, this can't happen. Thank you so much, guys. Forever in your debt. All right, so we are, we're going to recognize a few people here. We've got 8 awards in all. 5 are given tonight, but the first 3 I'd like to recognize are our All-State musicians, if we could. Julia Izquierdo, who just finished her audition for National Concert Choir. Come on up. She was in the SSAA chorus, and she just finished her audition for the All-National Chorus. She's going to find out in July if she made it. Stay there. Margaret Miao, 9-10 Orchestra Violin, All-State. And David Gonzalez in the mixed chorus. Where's David Gonzalez? He's supposed to leave his bow tie on, but I won't say anything. 3 All-State musicians. Give them a big round of applause. Thank you, guys. Thank you very much. Okay, we are going to give out. We're going to give out now 5 awards tonight. 3 awards, 3 music awards, will actually be given at the Academic Awards Ceremony, which takes place this Monday night in the Prep Gym. So there will be 3 more, but tonight we're going to give out 5. The first one is the John Philip Sousa Band Award. This award is given to a band member that demonstrates leadership, especially by setting an example of the highest standard of performance and dedication to the music program. He is the band president, the trumpet and low brass section leader, playing trumpet in wind ensemble, and jazz combo. He received superior ratings at both district and state solo ensemble festivals, a Maestro Solo Award in New Orleans, and the prestigious Ovation Award in New Orleans, given only to 2 students out of all of the participating schools. His enthusiasm for music is contagious. When he stands in front of the band to conduct or simply even just warm up the band, the respect he has earned from his fellow musicians is palpable. He has truly found his calling in music. With all of the adversities accompanied with cystic fibrosis, Chris is like the Rocky Balboa of trumpet players. He always keeps moving forward and never gives up. Trumpet, as he stated many times, has in many ways literally saved his life. Heading to the one and only University of Miami's Frost School of Music, the John Philip Sousa Award 2019 goes to Chris Ricardo. All right, the next one, the Patrick Gilmore Band Award 2019. This award is given to a band member that demonstrates leadership, especially by setting an example of the highest standard of performance and dedication to the music program. I have seen so much growth in this young man this year, and instead of succumbing to the senior slide, he has actually worked even harder this year. He is a versatile multi-instrumentalist playing violin, jazz, piano, and percussion. He is the vice president of band, and is always willing to lend a helping hand and go above and beyond the call of duty.
He even recently performed djembe for the Junior K Spring Concert with one of his fellow percussionists, and he had a blast. He loves music and is always inquiring about musical instruments and music theory, and he does it all with a smile on his face. His sense of humor and intelligent, quick wit is always a welcomed addition to the music room. He will be heading to Boston University in the fall, and no matter what his major is, I am sure music will always be a part of his life. Patrick Gilmore Band Award 2019 goes to the band vice president, Tadeo Acosta Rubio. Moving on to the National Choral Award 2019. This award is given to a chorus member that demonstrates leadership and true dedication to chorus and choral literature. This young lady's voice is simply unreal. Her tone quality, intonation, and ability to phrase is that of a seasoned professional, and she's only a junior. This year, she was chosen to the Florida All-State Women's Choir, and as mentioned earlier, has just sent off her audition for the All-National Concert Chorus. She is a leader with high expectations of her fellow musicians and is responsible for helping this year's vocal ensemble accomplish the highest levels of success. I sincerely hope she chooses music in some way, shape, or form in her future endeavors because the world needs to be filled with beautiful voices like hers. The National Choral Award 2019, Julia Izquierdo. Two left. The National Orchestra Award. This award is given to a string ensemble member that demonstrates leadership and technical proficiency, especially by setting an example of the highest standard of performance and dedication to the music program. This young man, in addition to being our concertmaster and string ensemble president, is an exemplary leader and representative for our prep music program. He helped to lead both the chamber strings and the string ensemble to superior ratings at both the district and state levels. Although he's a bit quiet, he leads by example and embodies the idea of actions speak louder than words. The National Orchestra Award 2019 goes to Mr. Matthew Garcia. And the last award for this evening, the Woody Herman Band Award 2019. This award is given to a band or string member that not only excels in wind or string ensemble, but also in jazz ensemble. Not only did he excel in jazz ensemble, but he picked up a brand new instrument last year to do so. He was even selected as the bassist for our jazz combo and has done a fantastic job laying down all different styles of bass lines. In addition to bass and viola, he is also in chorus and took AP Music Theory last year. And with all of this, he is one of the varsity baseball pitchers. He always finds a way to be dedicated to both his music and athletic families and will do whatever it takes to make it happen. And all of this on top of academics. He is one of the few students that truly grasps the idea of proactively managing a schedule. I am so proud of all he has accomplished, and I know he will go off and do amazing things. He is heading to the University of Richmond in the fall. The Woody Herman Band Award 2019 goes to John Jimbo Howard. All right, guys, show your plaque so you can get a photo op after they hug. It's almost over. All right, there we go. All right, guys, show your plaques. Photo op right here. Photo op.
2019 Music Department Award winners right there. Congratulations, guys. Congratulations.
Now's the time. Wow, that was amazing. As I forgot my notes on my stand, be right back. And I dropped that. It's okay. I'm very nervous and I'm getting very emotional. I'm sorry. I apologize. Can I get all the seniors up here, please? Give him a second. Oh, man. I don't know how people do this, man. I'm already starting. All right, so we are the GP Music Class of 2019 seniors, and we're all up here, and we want to say how much we really appreciate you both, Mr. C and Ms. Taylor. And how much we appreciate you and just how much we love you and how much we're going to miss you. So we have some things to give you and we have some things to say and then we have a little surprise after. So, oh man, Ms. Taylor, we know it's been a tough couple months for you and we talked about it and we decided what we wanted to give you was the opportunity to do something fun with Mr. Taylor. So please accept this token of appreciation and our scrapbook from the senior class. Please, if someone can go get it. Nick, that would be you. Yes, you're presenting. Yes, walk it over here. Yeah. Safe to say that Ms. Taylor has done a lot for us the past 4 years for all of us, and we love you and thank you. Now, Mr. C. Okay, all right. We're good. All right. Everyone here knows how incredibly hard you work to make us all sound so good. We figured that what you need is some rest and rap and relaxation in your happy place from all of these awards that you've been lugging around recently. So, on behalf of the senior class, we hope you will take this and use it to make your trip to Maine happen this summer. In addition, here's a basket to survive your long car ride up the East Coast. And lastly, we put together a scrapbook for you too. So to the both of you, a couple of us are going to say some things quickly, but we just all want to thank you individually. So I'm going to pass the mic to John. We'll start with him.
Mr. C, I'm going to start with Mrs. T. Mrs. T, you are the unsung hero of this music program. You got to see us evolve throughout our years here as we all grew closer over time. You were always there for us, bringing your electric smile to class every day, always sensing when something was wrong. You truly care about how each and every one of us is doing. Mrs. T, you're a true role model, and I don't know what I'll do without you next year. We love you, Mrs. T. Mr. C, to say what you have built here is special is a gross understatement. You have, through what seems like endless hard work, created a perfect music program, a perfect community, and a perfect family. Year after year, you adapt and make improvements while teaching a bunch of kids how to sound like professionals. But more importantly, turning a bunch of kids into fantastic adults. You teach the intangibles, the things that stick with a person for the rest of their life. This music program is nothing without you. I know at times it may seem that you are underappreciated, but it's because no one knows how truly special and absolutely unique you are until they have experienced this program. You reignited my passion for music and taught me that no matter what I end up doing, I must love doing it. You are the reason why I can look back on high school as one of the best times of my life. Thank you, Mr. C. I don't know how I could be so lucky to be standing on this stage right now addressing you at my final concert. I'm truly blessed. I wish to be half the man you are someday. And on behalf of every single one of your current and former students, we love you, we appreciate you, and we thank you both.
Mr. C, first thing I want to say is thank you. Thank you for all your patience and understanding, whether it was me missing for softball, or my anxiety playing alone, or me just going into class to bother you. I would not be at this school if it weren't for you. Thank you for giving me such an amazing opportunity. I am so grateful and lucky to have attended this amazing school. I've been holding off to write this because I don't want to face the matter of the fact that this is ending and I'm leaving, especially this program. When new students walk in during orientation, older kids talk about how much of a family this program is, and I didn't believe it when I first came in. Now that 4 years have passed, I've gotten so close to you, and I can truly say you guys have become family to me. This program has helped me meet some of my closest friends that I know will be lifelong friends. See, I absolutely adore your kids. I love when they come to the prep, and as soon as they see me, they scream my name and give me a hug. And I love that Summer comes up to me and she goes, "Dab me up, dab me up." I love your family and I'm so grateful to have you and them in my life. I know it's not a coincidence that I'm always on your bus. I love you too, C. As the school year is finishing and I realize I only have two more band-aids with you, I'm getting sadder and sadder because I know I can't walk in every day and give you a hug and ask how you're doing. Thank you for everything you do. It doesn't go unnoticed. And I hope you know I really appreciate everything you've done for me. Tamayo, you understand me on a whole nother level. Thank you for listening to all my crazy stories, laughing at all my dumb jokes, and being there for me for everything. You are so easy to talk to, and I could spend hours talking to you about anything and everything. We've gotten so close the past 4 years, and you've become like an older sister to me. You've helped me through some of the roughest times in my life, and I honestly don't know where I'd be without you. It really meant so much to me when you went to my senior softball game. That meant more to me than you could ever understand. And as the school year finishes, I can't walk in and pick you up and hug you, even though you've asked me a million times not to pick you up. But I want you both to know how much I'm truly gonna miss you. You both have not only made me a better musician, but a better person. I'm so grateful to have you two in my life. You and Tamayo are easily my favorite people of the prep. You have made such an impact on my life, and I can assure you two will be one of the few people I truly remember. I love you guys so much, and I will definitely come back to visit you.
I did a thing with mine. Let's see if at least C catches it. I first want to tell you all a story of how I fell in love with this music program. When I came in here freshman year, I was a scared little boy of about the same height. That's not funny. Whatever. I was scared because Mr. C had a big beard. But now I like the beard. You should bring it back. We're playing music that at first sight seemed way beyond my capabilities, not to mention that was my first year and our last in the last 4 years where we played a full orchestra set. We played a Beethoven march, a Tchaikovsky waltz, and my favorite classical piece of all time, the legendary Lilting Lullaby that is the fourth movement of Brahms' First Symphony. I've been waiting for the past 3 years to play a full orchestra piece again, and now apparently next year is the year, so I better be getting that music, and I'll actually be here, playing with you all by your side on the stage. And the point I'm trying to make here is, I was making all this amazing music with these amazing musicians, and it really put me in the mood for the years to come. So, oh, he's getting it. So I want to thank everyone who has made the last 4 years of my high school formation smooth as silk. People like my stand partners in the string ensemble, like Lewis, who's here tonight, I love him, and Andrea this year, and they're both incredible musicians. My respective section leaders and all the ensembles that I've been in, and the people older and younger than me who have taught me many a thing, like Arnau and Jason this year, who are both incredible musicians. I also want to thank Miss Tamayo, whom I refuse to call Mrs. Taylor, because I can't believe she's all grown up and married. They grow up so fast. And of course, I want to thank Mr. C for not only teaching me many things musically, but also in many other aspects of life as well. You've been an inspiration, a role model, and a dad. I know sometimes I can be quite a head case, but when it comes to loving you, I see the love in your eyes too. I think the most important thing you've taught me, though, is that if I tread lightly, I'll stay on the right track.
I don't know how I'm going to top that, but I'll try. I'm a mess. I dropped my award. I'm an emotional wreck. I just can't, man. It's hard. So, Mr. C, Miss Taylor, I'm going to start with the first thing I ever said to you guys, which was pretty stupid. It was freshman year, and you had this amazing full beard, and then one day you shaved it, and I went up to you and I said, "Hey, C, your face went bald." "What?" And immediately after I said that, I was like, "What the, how could I?" And Miss Taylor looked at me like, "Really, man? Really?" But it's a true story. You just looked at me like the nice guy you are, and you said, "Huh, that's a new one. Nice." And at that moment, I realized that you guys were pretty cool. And back then, I had no idea that you guys were going to make such an impact on my life. I saw you every day for 4 years, and I can honestly say it never got old. You made the band room my home away from home to the point where I can call you both family. You both raised me, practically. You put a lot of love and effort into helping me grow as a musician and as a young man. I don't know how I can try and ever thank you for that. I'm still trying to figure that out. So it hit me when I was sitting at Flanagan's with Courtney and Mason and how I'm not going to be here next year, and I won't be in any of you guys' ensembles, but that this is it. But I also realized how grateful I am towards you guys. And because of everything that you've done for me and all the wonderful memories that we've had that I'll cherish forever, whether it's winning a lot of awards at NOLA, Memphis, or Orlando, or simply just talking about a baked potato that we love. So, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for everything, and I'll leave you with this before I pass it on to Kellyanne. The mediocre teacher tells. The good teacher explains. The superior teacher demonstrates. But the great teacher inspires. And that is what you guys have done for me. Thank you both. I love you. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. C, and thank you, Ms. Taylor, for everything. I recently saw a sign that said, "Caution, exposure to music may cause sudden outbursts of joy, happiness, energy, creativity, awareness, and spontaneous healing. Handle at your own risk." Well, thanks to you, Mr. C and Ms. Taylor, the exposure you gave us, Gulliver Raiders, class of 2019, created one extremely happy class. We have number one, Outbursts of Joy. We slammed in New Orleans. I felt sorry a little bit for the competition, maybe a little bit. The only bad part about New Orleans, well, the trophy was humongous, and it was quite heavy to carry. Number two, Happiness. How can we thank you for giving us the opportunities over the years to come before an audience and sing to share all our music before hundreds of people in the University of Miami? Three, A Surge of Energy. You taught us to direct our energy to give our best performance, and I think we did the best we could. We wanted to show you our best. And four, Creativity. We experimented, tried different styles of music, music I never thought I would have ever worked on. We won big awards for Gulliver. And five, most important, spontaneous healing. I remember, and I believe that all music, all singing, all tears, and all the hard work and prayers, Mr. Taylor has received tremendous healing and hope for a new day, a new beginning, because of the rising of all our spirits in song. And that's a gigantic thanks to you both. I came to Gulliver because of you both. And I remember the first audition. I immediately felt your knowledge, your compassion, and your sincere care for our well-being. Well, thank you. Thank you for keeping this amazing program growing. And for next year's music students, hold on tight. Handle this journey with so much care. And remember that this music journey is at your own risk. But I can promise you, it will be a journey that will change your life for the better.
Without tearing him in half, group hug on Mr. C, Ms. Taylor. Let's go. All right, break.
Thank you so much, guys. That was awesome. What are you talking about? What is this? Whoa, exposure to me. And you guys all signed this? This is awesome. Look at this, guys. This is awesome. Signed by all the seniors. Caution, exposure to music may cause sudden outbursts of joy, happiness, energy, creativity, awareness, and spontaneous healing. Handle at your own risk. Thank you so much, seniors. This is awesome. Thank you, guys. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, seniors. This is a really special senior class. Can we give the senior class a round of applause, please? Seniors 2019. I know this happens, it's a tradition that happens every spring concert, and I so appreciate you indulging those seniors. It means a lot to them, and it means a lot to Mrs. Taylor and I. This is the end of a four-year incredible journey, and I'm so happy that alumni come back. I wish more did. So thank you, seniors. Let's close this out now on a happy note. Let's do some Groovin' Hard. Groovin' Hard, featuring Kyle Bramson. Thank you all for coming tonight. This is the last chart.
Two.
Gulliver Prep Jazz Ensemble, Gulliver Prep Jazz Ensemble. Kyle Bramson on the solo, Jake Vine on the drums. Thank you so much, that was Groovin' Hard. Thank you so much for an awesome spring concert and being here and supporting these amazing musicians. Have a great summer, guys. Thank you so much.